Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Thursday, which means it's a throwback Thursday, and I always try to keep it authentic with the things that I throw back to. It's usually they're sparked off by something I have seen during the day or whatever. So today, I'm sending shout outs to all our old school parenting type of parents. Yeah, I'm talking about the type of parenting. Actually, I'm throwing back to old school parenting. Remember when you were young and your mother just gave you the look? She didn't have to say much. She didn't have to move or flinch or tweet. She just gave you that. And you would know everything she is saying. You would know she has already bought a plot of land. She has already found out what to do to your body. That kind of parenting. I miss it. But nowadays, you find parents are trying to talk to their kids. Oh, baby, listen, will it desire, you know, you see. Not the parents that raised us. We all know the parents that raised us didn't have that time. But it begs the question, though. Our parents didn't have time for all this sentimental, emotional crap and talking to the kids. We turned out all right, didn't we? I think we did. You turned out all right, Josephine, didn't you? What's the difference? What went wrong with the millennial parents? Anyway, I'm throwing back to old school parenting. That's my throwback for today. Anyway, my name is Tina Fierce One. The show is proudly sponsored by Fanta. Let's get it. If you honestly ask me today, I almost didn't want to do the show because there's not much I can do. We sat down with the team. We're trying to look for Agawoma, Agononese, Nebikana, Biabusena. And you know, consolation that it's Thursday, I can do a video review. Then I was like, yay, video review, that should be easy. There's tons of music that has come out. Apparently, now when we do video reviews, all these artists are just waiting to remind us there's a copyright law. Put your video up on my YouTube space and then they'll just, you know, what they need to do. But I'm not about to risk that. Do you know how big the family on YouTube is? But I'll still review these videos without audio. Hey, Osaga! Over the weekend, I saw beautiful photos. There were images that I actually even shared on my different social media platforms. It was Weasel with the Let Radio Moses kids and his baby mama. It was a good moment, you know? It was nice to look at those little kids. They actually look like they're pups. But that's besides the point. Now, I've been seeing this whole initiative going out around the time when the Let Radio passed, which is actually next year, around the 3rd of February, we've had 4th. People are going to be converging down at his mother's village, at his where he's buried, and I think they're going to celebrate life. Then someone asked me, but Tina, how can you people keep milking and milking and milking radio? He's gone, Mumuleke, let the man rest in peace. I would buy into that. I would. Like, I thought it would have been something for his family, you know, close family and friends, if they wanted to do something in his, you know, in his memory. But here's the thing you people have forgotten. Radio was not just radio. He was our radio too. He was the public's radio. So I suggest if you're the part of the public and you want to go pay your respects, yeah, I think they're going to be letting all of us come in it. I think so. It's a good thing. I saw his kids with Lillian Babazi grown, looking beautiful. It's always good to know that as the years pass by, we're not going to keep forgetting him. We can't forget him. We will not forget him. There's little bits of him around us. So, yay. Next month is going to be marking 2 years since his demise. And for all of you who get the memo and you want to show up, please do show up in numbers, you know. Just go and check on our ninja. Just that. Now, since I have to step lightly with these video reviews, I will definitely step lightly because, one, I want to review the song and give you my opinion on it, but some people just want us, they won't let us relax in this January. But anyway, here goes. The first song that I want to review today is Jose Chameleone, Leila Kayondo, Nyumirwa. reviewing. I want to ask Mr. Kamili. Chameleon, what did Leila Kayondo do for you? Because I have seen many people ask you for collabos and you just go like, But when Leila hits you up, it's always so easy for you to do collabos with her. And here's what I'm going to say. I can't stress it enough, Leila. You need to find a side hustle. You really need to. Or you really need to go the same way that, you know, Helen Lukoma went. Go get your woman, get you wiped up. Because this whole singing thing, it is just not doing well for you. It refused. Like Chagana, Chireke, Chumumuze. All one is a judge. And I'm going to show you Chibudeko, the song, Nyumirwa. I wasn't even going to review it. And then someone was like, AOT, AOT, you need to listen to this song, or better yet, watch this song. The visuals are beautiful. When I say the visuals, I mean, Echifanani Nijeno, Chameleon in his different outfits, because damn, he looked fine. Atake Jatakoga looked beautiful in this video. Now, as for you, Leila, when I'm going to the visuals, well, I Josephine Sirimba. Leila used to have this nice, beautiful, long face. I'm being honest. If you asked me the most beautiful women from Uganda, this would be my lineup. The ones that I think are beautiful. Leila Kayondo, before she got the Mayuge. Helen Lukoma. Yes, that girl's face is beautiful. And then the one and the only, Oli, she's timeless, she's priceless. Natasha Sinayobe. And then just to salt it in, I'll put Lillian Mbabazi. Because she look good. I don't know. This is something I like about Lillian. So, Leila, the outfits in this song, I don't know what you're going for. I just never know what you're going for, Leila. You've gained so much weight, but you're trying so hard to stay the Slay Queen late. Like, dress your body according to you, the dictation it is giving you. Back in the day, you were skinny and dark, and we liked that. Made you look good. Now, you're not fat, but you're not skinny. Particular parts of your body are gaining weight. That is to say, around the midsection here and here, the rest of you is small. What's happening? Anyway, song starts to play and I wanted to throw up. I wanted to break my PC. I just wanted to look for whoever even thought of the idea. They should have been put on death row. What in the world were you doing, Leila? Were you singing or talking? The only highlight of this song is Chameleon. Because you, Chameleon reminds me of Bebe Cool, Chameleon. Who else? Who else sits so well on any hook? Raggedy. Those guys, give them any hook, they will sit on it so perfectly. And now Chameleon represented it in the song. He did. He didn't have to do so much, but he did represent, which was good. I like the sound. I like the look. And I know he also knew what he was singing along to his garbage, but he had no option. Someone paid for that video and that collaboration, and it seems they're friends. So, Leila. I thought after the other dancing video we just saw last year of you trying to do dancing with the dancer and that whole thing was the only thing you were going to make us hate our lives with. You went ahead and did a song called Nyumirwa. Naenga bwemba andulaba. What is the opposite of Okunyumirwa? Joseph, what's the opposite of Okunyumirwa? Sikaba. Wallahi mbadden kaba. Good God, that's a pathetic song. I'm now trying to remind myself what I could have done in those 5 minutes. You know, I could have done something in those 5 minutes and not just be, God, Leila. Can't we try to find for Leila, like, new hustles? If anybody wanted, would you think Leila would be a good actress? I don't think so. I'm just going to sit down and try to get Leila different hustles. Because this singing thing, no. We are in 2020, Leila. We shall not, I repeat, we shall not be dealing with such nyokari. We can't. Tusasire muko. Nawe we tunule mu. Before you release these songs, tell your honest close friends to tell you the truth. what do I sound like? What does this song say to you? All I hear is a lot of nyam, nyam, nyam. Sound like a girl from some Muzigo. The song is in your mirror. Take time if you have plenty to waste. And watch it. You'll see what I'm saying. I was talking to some friend of mine who is part of the hip-hop fraternity, and he was like, AOT, you don't even put respect on our names. As rappers, we're out here, we're doing music, you never review our music, you never really talk about us, you never even do nothing about us. It's like we're non-existent in the industry. And this is what I have to say to all my hip-hop fraternity friends. What? We cannot begin talking about you if there's nothing to talk about. Y'all have zero controversies because most of the times y'all is broke. Your beefs, I can't even, are they called beefs or beef? Your beef is never controversial enough for me. Like, I've tried to find a way of moments. I've tried to find moments when I could talk about hip hop, but I have nothing, man. I have nothing until Willis came in the other day and he was singing a hook that caught my fancy, you know? He was singing a certain hook. I asked him what's the name of the song and he's like, the title of the song is Bomboclat. I'm like, so who did the song? And he goes, Wyke Bender, Don MC Capata, Enough, and then you have Big Trill on there, then you have Navio on there, and then you have, there's another version with GNL on it. I'm like, oh, fire, snap, that should sound nice. Because in my mind, I was thinking, you have Wyke Bender on the hook, that is definitely sure fire. And then you have Santana and all of these different rappers doing their thing, it's definitely going to be sure fire. It's been a minute since we had those all-stars, because there was a time when there were thing when you had different artists come on a track and kill it. So I expected the same effect till I played the song. I would have talked about the video, but the video is too lackluster for me. It is basically the video for Bomboclat is hip-hop video 101. It's the same-ish. Only thing that confused me is the storyline and the relatability to what the rappers are talking about. I was confused. This song is so confusing, by the way. It seems like a song to keep you woke, but then again, it doesn't seem that serious for you to stay woke. And then again, it's serious. This song confused me. One minute they're talking about haters, and then the next minute they're talking about this. I'm like, wait! Which direction is this song going to? Which one? Then it came my hip-hop stars. First of all, I would like to tell you, Wyke Bender, in the near foreseeable future, I am begging you, because this is something etched in my memory, please don't take off your shirt in videos. Please don't. You have girl boobs. You have girl boobs. Like, when I look at your chest, I just go like, oh, snap, the five-year-old girl came to swim too. Just don't take off your shirt, boo-boo. Don't. Until you get muscle and ripped and all of that. Another thing I wanted to tell Wyke Bender. I understand why you like to wear shades. It's the only time you look serious. Because in this video, he was trying to be mean, hard and lean without shades on. And I kept looking at his face like, are you serious? I'm not scared. Now let's move away from Wyke Bender's verse in this song, because he did his hook a crazy solid. He I believe for a hook that short with only like two words, he killed it. He did. Then we went to my rappers. If you ask me who brought the bars in this particular song, I can't believe I'm going to say this. Expected Big Trill. I did. I expected Big Trill to come through like crazy, like shred them, kill them, show them why Cardi B and Offset was dancing to their song and to your song in their limo. Then he came back with the 1, 2, 3 bars, the same bars he moved away when he moved away from those bars when he was, even in Baboon Forest, he was sicker than that. I was like, okay, that's a letdown. I moved from Big Trill. And then came Navio. I'm like, okay. Even if the bars are not hard, he's finna accentuate and give them, you know, that nice hip-hop feel. I was let down. Danny, what's happening? Where's that fire? Where's that hunger? Where's that culture that raised you? You could have done better. I think the only person who actually caught my fancy would have been Don MC Kapata. I don't even know how. Because, I mean, we're among the people who used to tell him to just stop rapping and go on the runway. He tried to do something. Fefe Busi, where was your direction with your verses? Where? You see, I keep telling people, music is not just music. Because someone called you and put you on their song doesn't mean you have to come with any nonsense. Did anyone proofread these bars? Of course, the one with JNL Zamba did sound a lot much better because he had to write his bars and see if, you know, because right now he's in like a very tight spot. Ugandans still want to see if he still has that lyrical prowess. But Mamba Clad, I think it was a worst of a lineup. Very talented MCs up there, but I think it was hastily done too. And if I had it my way, wallahi, I would want for them to redo this one with thicker bars. There you go, hip hop. I did something about the culture. And that is how my Thursday with Zero Lugamba. But now, mwononeko nkoye nkutuka. But still, on the real though, since we're talking about music and the culture, I think those are two videos that you should watch for you to understand why I feel let down. Like, it's 2020, I believe. We should have better. We should be aiming for bigger than this. But hey, that's what we've got. But I still love the song. Not songs. Leila Kayondo, even if they put me on gunpoint to like this your song, I'll try to like Bombo Clat. I'll mute out some artists and just listen to the chorus. That works for me. Anywho, it's been my time this Thursday. I'll catch you on the flip side, which is tomorrow or Friday. So at Tina Fierce One is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and at Tina Fierce One. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's at Tina Fierce One with an H. And on Snapchat, it's at Tina Fierce One. Those who want to complain that today's episode was boring, I'm giving you a day to actually complain. Hit me in the comment section. For now, I'm out. Peace.
Scoop and Scoop was sponsored by